backups. The one thing you keep hearing me talk about is backup, backup, backup. Honestly, this is something that needs to be your priority. Even if somebody else takes care of the backups for you, you should be ensuring that those backups are being run, maybe even running another copy of the backups of your critical files yourself, so that you have them just in case. Now, when it comes to backups, people don't understand how backups work. There's a difference between backups, archives, rotations, different backup strategies, whether it's online or offline. Let's just do a few basics here. You think of a typical backup program that you run on your computer. It can back up to perhaps an external USB hard drive. Maybe it's connected to a little thumb drive. Maybe it's going to onto an online account. Well, those backups that you have running are always keeping up with whatever the latest files are. So if you got infected with, say, a ransomware and it started encrypting your files, it would start backing up those encrypted files. So now those backups are no good. So on that note, what you need to do is have the ability to go back in time through what we call snapshots or offline backups. This is where it's great to have 3 external hard drives. That's my recommendation, is 3. And the reason for that is because one external hard drive is connected to your device, your computer, your laptop, and it's backing up files to that. There's another one that's stored off-site at a safe location. And then there's the one third device that is in transit between them. That way you never have all of your backup drives at the same location at the same time. That avoids a problem of losing all your files. Now, on that note, this is a system for keeping track of offline files. That's when real disaster strikes and you need to go recover something. You want to make sure that you also have an automatic backup solution. One of my favorites is using a site called Backblaze. Backblaze has a very reasonable fixed annual fee, and it has unlimited data that you can back up. And for somebody like me, I have huge amounts of data on my computer between photos from trips and files attached to different devices and whatnot. It will back up all of that information. You don't get charged extra. Backblaze is great because it's very simple. There are many other online cloud-based backup programs that you can subscribe to if you want, but look at the features and how they work and if there's any limitations on size. Now, the first time that you run the program, it needs to create what's called a seed, which is your baseline backup of all of your files. That can take weeks, maybe even longer, depending on how many files you have, and depending on how fast or slow your internet connection is. After that point, when it's created the initial baseline backup, at that point, then it only needs to back up daily the changes of files. So any files that are modified, any new files you made, any files you deleted, that's all it's backing up from that point forward. The other thing that you want to make sure is that any of your physical backups that you do on external hard drives or USB thumb drives, that you are physically securing those things. Maybe you put them in a fire safe, maybe you put them in a bank safety deposit box. Whatever it is, you want to make sure that somebody can't just go and grab that easily. And then you will have a problem because they have unrestricted access to all your files. Unless, of course, you're password protecting that device and or encrypting the contents. But a lot of people I know, they just do it for convenience. So it's a straight copy, their files are on their device, and if anybody got a hold of that, it'd be pretty bad. So evaluate your current situation for your files. Evaluate which ones are critical, and you need to take responsibility to ensure that those files are being backed up and they're being backed up in different methods, as well as ensuring that you have offline backups in case disaster strikes from something such as ransomware.